Hello everyone, my name is Vittorio. Now, what am I doing here? Well, I'm here to show you, first of all, the new racket. New Feathers racket. This came out, launch date is October 1st. Managed to get it a little bit earlier, a little bit sooner, let's say. Now, this is it. RF97 autograph. Now that means that there's his signature right here. That means that this racket is the Pro Staff 97. That means that this racket is a little bit heavier than the other model. They came up with four different ones. This is the heaviest one. This is 340 grams, which is equivalent in 12 ounces without strings, unstrung. Now once you put the strings on, they're generally between 15 to 18 grams, roughly, depending on the strings. Then when you put an overgrip on, and you put a dumper on, you're adding some weight to it. We're getting close to 370 grams here. It's probably 365, 368. So it has some heft. It's a racket that has some weight to it. Now, the good thing about it is that this racket is pretty headlight. That means is that the balance of this racket, it's kind of uncomfortable to do here, but you know, let's do it like this. The balance of this racket, it's, you know, it's towards the handle more. See, some rackets balance right here. Those are kind of centered balanced. Zero, let's say in the middle, if you get half of the racket. This one balances more towards the handle. So that means that there's more weight on the handle and a little bit less distributor on the head. So that makes it a little bit more, well, not a little bit, quite a bit more maneuverable given the weight. If this racket had the same weight, like about 370 grams, a little less, but it was balanced more in the middle, it would be kind of harder to swing, you know, to whip, to move around, maneuver. So that's called, you know, so it gives it a lower swing weight. The swing weight is how well, I don't know if that's the proper description, the definition of it, but it's how well the racket moves through the air, you know, moving it from the handle, like this movement, like this. But anyway, let's get back to us. Now, I'm testing this racket. I got it last night, got home, I strung it really late at night, because I'm maniac like that. I'm, you know, kind of like, I wanted to string it, I had to string it, because today I had the day off, it's Friday, but I had a day off and I wanted to come and try it. So I hit for 2 hours with a friend of mine, a big hitter, and felt pretty good. Felt different compared to my other rackets. I played with the Bocal Power Bridge 10 mid, so they're smaller, they're way smaller. But overall, I played pretty well. I mean, I hit pretty well with it. Really stable at impact, has a really good sweet spot. So even if you don't get the ball dead center, get a little bit on a side, you know, which can happen. You know, we're not like, even the pros miss hit it, so you can imagine us, right? Common mortals. It still feels good because of the weight, because of the heft, you know, so it has that plow through. The racket's weight fights the ball more. So that means that the racket works for you more. So, you know, the ball is the same weight. The weight of the ball doesn't change. So heavy racket fights the ball better. Once you got this racket in motion and you got it to the contact point, then the racket works for you. So it moves through the ball better. So the ball doesn't slow down the speed of the racket as much as it would if you had a lighter racket. If that makes sense. Well, it does make sense. It has to make sense. Anyway, now, what else can I say? Felt pretty good. Kind of tired. I didn't sleep that much, but I'm like a little kid, even though I'm not a little kid anymore, but I have that excitement still in me. Il fanciullino, we say in Italy, fanciullino da Machiavelli, actually, he's a writer. He wrote something about il fanciullino, that, you know, every one of us has like this little kid inside, and I sure do have it. So anyway, I was so happy when I got the package last night, and could not wait to try it. So, pretty good racket. It's hard to tell right away. I just hit with it for like about 2 hours. I hit some serve before. I'm about to hit some other serves because I want to get used to it, because it moves through the air
little bit differently than my other rackets, vocals. So like everything, you have to get adjusted to it.
Let me move this a little bit around. Now,
you don't get adjusted to it really, really quickly. Strokes and serves and everything. The volleys felt really sweet, actually. As long as you put the racket in front of you, you're good. You know, volley with this racket, with any hefty racket. Hefty, I mean anything that has some weight. Anything that's over 12 ounces, it's 12, 12.5, 12.6, 13, even over 13. Those rackets, you can't keep it down like this when you're at the net. I mean, it's not proper to do anyway, because at the net, you want to be ready like this. This is the position you want to have it, racket in front of your eyes. So that's ideal. So this racket, if you keep it in front of you and, you get the ball in front of you, you just need to do, minor movement. You don't need to take a big swing, because the heft of the racket will actually work for you. So this is a really good racket involvement. Now, something I would like to say, if you're playing doubles, why am I mentioning that? Because when you play doubles, you need to be really quick at the net. So you're there, your partner is serving, you're there at the net, and you're waiting for your opponent to hit the ball back to you. So you're at the net most of the times, there, and the ball is going to come to you sometimes, or it can come to you. So sometimes if your partner doesn't serve great, that ball could come to you really fast from, inside the court. So if the serve is short and your opponent attacks the ball, comes in the court like a few feet, 4 or 5 or more feet, then you got to be quick. Then that's a little problem. You have to be really quick in moving this racket. So this racket is not the easiest to move quickly through the air to volley. It's great when you have time. So let's say if you serve and volley, you have time to, do the split step, volley, and then move on. So that's a really good racket for that type of game. But for doubles, I don't know. Anything that is this heavy for doubles, you really have to be fit. You have to be quick. You have to have, really good reflexes. You have to have them anyway, but with a heavy racket, last minute tweak or something. You can't rotate this racket quickly with your wrist.
not a racket that's not meant for that. I mean, at least I can't, but it's solid, it's heavy, so it also, you know. So it's a racket that requires some form, requires proper technique to be used. And if you don't have a proper technique, I'm sure you will learn it with this, because it will not function if you do not do the right movement. So it could be a racket also that it'll improve your game for sure, but it's definitely not for someone that's starting to play, because it could be, you know, they'll get tired really soon, and it could be depressing because, you know, it's not going to do what you want it to do. You're going to play the balls, you're going to open it, you're going to hit the balls, or, you know, not flush on this, but you can hit them behind you because you cannot get to the proper position, to the impact zone on time. So, but, you know, the more you play with it, the more you can get adjusted to that. But again, you need to be strong. You need to have some muscles and some form to handle it. Now, there's also a lighter version. This is the 340, 340 grams and strong. There's the 315 version that it's not the autograph, the RF97. And that racket, I'm sure, is going to be more popular than this one because it's going to fit more players. It's going to be a good racket for more players. It's a racket that you can also customize if you feel that it's too light. Because for 315, it's 25 grams lighter than this, about an ounce when I talk ounces. So, you know, that's a racket you can still customize. You can still add weight in the handle, on the hoop up here, on the sides, 9 o'clock, inside here in the middle. You can do whatever you want. You can use lead tape. So nowadays, that's easy to do. So that's another thing. So that racket, it's definitely going to be more successful. It's going to be sold more than this one because it's more versatile. Love Roger Federer, who doesn't? So that's pretty much why I bought this racket. I didn't really need another racket. I have plenty of rackets. I have the Vocals that I'm playing with now that I love them, but I had to buy it just for the sake of it. I said, well, this is his racket. Who knows, maybe it's the last racket that he's ever gonna use on the tour, because, you know, at some point he might retire, right? So this is probably the last racket that he's gonna use. And I had to have it. Then if it's not the last racket, it doesn't matter. But I wanted to buy it anyway. And I'm here to try it, to try to serve with it, okay? So I'll try, okay? I'm not a pro, but I'll do my best, okay?